Three, two, one.
Greetings and welcome to the second ever episode of Channel 7 Horizon Online News.
Because you, dear viewer, are watching this second monumental episode of K7HUN, Channel 7 Horizon Online News, you probably fall into one of two categories. Either you're a lifetime watcher, with us all the way from episode 1, or you're a first-time viewer, slightly confused at what is going on. Regardless of who you are, I'd just like to take the time to tell you that you can now relive or catch up on all the laughs, the tears, and the happenings of K7HUN, as well as all your Heston College news that used to be in a paper at horizon.heston.edu. Or just use the little pull-down thingy on the right of the Heston College website and click on Heston College Horizon. Anyways, back to the newsy bits. A commuter plane crash-landed into a house in Clarence, New York on Thursday night, 6 miles shy of the runway it was intending to land on. All 49 people on the plane, as well as one person inside the house, were killed. While nothing has been announced, it is suspected that ice buildup on the aircraft is the blame for the accident. Congress passed a $787 billion stimulus bill late Friday night, simultaneously giving hope to America's financially troubled and crushing the hope for those who are expecting a more bipartisan Congress, with every Democrat voting for the bill and all but 3 Republicans voting against the bill, including House Republican leader John Boehner, who reportedly even threw down the 1,071-page bill to the floor in contempt of it. Soon after, however, Boehner was told to clean up the scattered bill in a scene that much resembled a literal interpretation of 52-card pickup, except times 20, and with more shame. And pork. Abraham Lincoln, who would have turned 200 last Thursday if not for his assassination, was recently ranked as the number one president in American history by a panel of historians, who ranked Washington second, FDR third, Teddy Roosevelt fourth, and George W. Bush 36th. Lincoln is best remembered for his leadership during the Civil War, his signing of the Emancipation Proclamation, and, according to his statue at the Lincoln Memorial, the fact that he was a giant. General Motors and Chrysler LLC have until tomorrow to submit restructuring plans to the U.S. government as part of their $17.4 billion in federal aid plan. While we've heard nothing from Chrysler, General Motors has said that after much customer polling, in-depth research, and fasting, they had determined that we need to make more of these things, less of these things, and none of these things. Last Sunday was host to the 51st Grammy Awards, an event that has been scientifically proven as moderately boring. The biggest winners of the night were Alison Krauss and Robert Plant, with 5 awards for their album Raising Sand, including Album and Record of the Year. Lil Wayne came away with 4 awards, including Best Rap Album, and Coldplay came away with only 3 awards, preventing their inevitable world domination using generic soft alternative rock by at least another year. Ha 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 ha! Coldplay. And now, for a bit more local news, last Thursday was the International Festival, a dinner and program put on by the international students of Heston College. If you missed it, there was wonderful food from many different countries, and a very entertaining variety show type thingy afterwards. And, by the magic of hokey amateur news programming, one of our reporters, C.D. Leadfly, is live on the scene. Last Thursday. It makes more sense if you don't think about it. Anyways, C.D., I'm poking my finger inside my ear for no apparent reason. Can you hear me?
Yeah, I hear you. I'm standing outside here, the Bontrager student section, the dining hall, Heston College, and tonight is the International Festival. So we're gonna go inside and ask a few questions. If you come along. They had these pretty lights up here and the streamer stuff. Yeah, it's a pretty good deal. I heard the food was amazing. They had like chicken and macaroni and cheese. I thought that was American, but I guess not. Okay. Do you like America?
Yeah, I like America.
What do you like about America?
Yeah, I like it too.
What do you like about it?
Because America's a really good country.
How did you find out about Heston College?
I met the advisor Dave Osborne. He talked about the Heston College. Heston is nice and good for me because I've never been to America. So yeah, it was good place for me to study.
Have you ever worn spurs before?
No, never.
I never.
Never?
Yeah.
That's too bad. You should wear them. They're fun.
Yeah, I know.
Hi there. What's the biggest thing you miss about your country?
Well, I miss the food a lot.
You miss the food from your country?
Yep. This food tonight very much reminded me of the food from my country.
It's good to hear. What country are you from?
America.
Will you complete this sentence for me? If I were a wild stallion upon the prairie, I would... What's the least thing that you miss about your country?
The least thing?
Yes.
Yes.
The hectic situation of the country.
Of the country. It's not hectic here in America?
I think it's more stable in here.
If you and I were to get in a fight, who would win?
I don't know. Probably me.
You think you'd beat me?
Of course.
Whatever. Hey, Dwight.
Yeah.
I love grits.
You love grits?
I love grits.
Why do you love grits?
Because grits are good.
I love grits too. They're good.
Yeah. What's the biggest difference between your country and here in America?
Food.
Is the food better here or back home?
Well, they're just different. I can't compare. It's like comparing orange and apple, you know.
I read you.
That is apparently all we have from CD. Oh, well.
Hello, and welcome to the weather. Yay, weather. Today on our ethnocentric weather map, showing the United States, we can see, well, the United States, and also some of Mexico, and some of South America, and, well, we can see Canada, but really, who cares? Sorry, Barry, but really... except for Tim Hortons. Well, back to weather. So this week in the weather, and you know, today, we will be having, well, it'll be between hot as the sun and cold as, you know, ice or whatever's cold, you know, it'll maybe lukewarm or something, you know, it'll sustain life, I'm pretty sure. So, United States weather and... thanks for joining. Welcome to the weather, and bye.
Also, happy birthday today to Kim Jong-il, the leader of the Democratic People's Republic of Korea. You make free world leaders scared. Also, happy birthday tomorrow to Jonathan Burenu and Kaelin Boschart. If I've mispronounced your names, I'm really sorry. But in a couple years, if you still feel wronged, come find me. I'll be waiting. And that's all we have for Channel 7 Horizon Online News. Until next time, keep passing all your classes and stay away from ill-tempered animals.